Lakers. We hope you enjoyed your snow day Monday.
Yeah, there seems to be a theme of 4-day school weeks this month.
No kidding. As much as I like snow days, I really hope this November is no indicator for how the rest of the winter is going to be.
Yeah, I'd kind of like to graduate sometime before August. Anyways, enough ranting. Let's get on with the snow. I mean show.
I see what you did there. On Thursday, many Americans will be stuffing their face with turkey and gravy, but a couple of organizations here at Calloway have been trying to help people who may not have the perfect Thanksgiving. Beta Club and Lakers for Christ came together to organize a school-wide food drive. Jacob Barton brings us the story.
While Thanksgiving is a time many people direct their attention to their own family, Beta sponsor Lisa Harrison encourages everyone to think of others.
So I believe that any way that we can help by donating this food, knowing that it's going to be distributed to needy families who not just necessarily for Thanksgiving, but who need it day to day, I think that's a very worthwhile cause.
Harrison appreciates what it's like to be on the receiving end.
When I went through breast cancer, many of my fellow teachers would bring us meals. So that my husband would have one less worry, you know, trying to take care of two young children and then me not feeling like doing those things. And so yes, we have received a lot of help in that way. And I think they receive as much from it as we did. And I don't know if they'll ever know how grateful we were for their help.
Remember that even though the CCHS food drive ends today, doesn't mean you still can't give to those in need throughout this coming holiday season. For LakerTV, I'm Jacob Barton.
Harrison says they'll be taking all the food donated so far to Needline today, but the boxes will remain around the school through next Tuesday for anyone who still wants to donate.
Ms. Harrison just shared with us the story about a difficult time in her life when she faced a battle with breast cancer. There are many women in the world who are struggling through this deadly disease. Fortunately for many, it's only a bump in the road that you can pass over.
I was very shocked. No one in my family has ever had cancer. And I was really in disbelief until on the way home and it hit me and I couldn't quit crying.
CCHS business teacher Vicki Simmons was diagnosed with cancer in March of 2012.
That's the problem. You multiply and add them all together.
I've always been a positive person, but it really makes you appreciate every day that you live.
1 in 8 women will develop breast cancer over the course of their lifetime.
How has it changed my life? Well, things are just different. I can't do everything that I used to could do.
Tane Alexander, also known as Tango the Balloon Lady, is a professional clown who was diagnosed last year with breast cancer. She has managed to work through this obstacle. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, in 2011, 220,097 women and 2,078 men were diagnosed with breast cancer. And unfortunately, 40,931 women and 443 men passed away.
I still have radiation to go. I have 30 treatments, one a day, for 6 weeks. And I start that next week. So when I get that done, it'll be all over, and hopefully we'll never have to think about this again.
It makes me feel great now. When I was going through it, you know, I never knew if I was going to live the next day because some days I felt horrible. But a positive attitude and knowing a good day would come helped me through it.
If there's someone that you know that's struggling with this disease, just remember to be motivational for them and have a positive outlook.
These kinds of life experiences allow us to have a new appreciation for the simpler things in life. Just being there and having a positive attitude can show them that there is hope for everyone. So if you know anyone around you with breast cancer or some other serious health issue, the best thing you can do for them is provide encouragement and be their biggest cheerleader.
Speaking of cheerleaders, tomorrow marks the beginning of the regional cheer competition taking place at McCracken County High School. Reporter Alyssa Bodway tells us the Lakers squad has been hard at work preparing.
Calloway County varsity cheerleaders are heading to compete in a fierce competition this weekend to represent our school.
We've been practicing since basically the beginning of cheerleading, like tryouts basically.
Good luck to all the CCHS varsity cheerleaders. For LakerTV, I'm Alyssa Bodway.
Pretty soon, the Laker cheerleaders will be busy on the sidelines, cheering on the basketball teams. The season opens December 2nd for the girls' team, and this week, reporter Josh Bailey has a preview of the Lady Lakers basketball season.
We know that we are a team in rebuilding. This is probably my first team in a long, long time where I've had to either rebuild or retool.
After a mediocre season last year, the Lady Lakers are hoping to redeem themselves as a serious district and regional contender.
In years past, the team has been a district dynasty, winning 3 district titles in just 8 years, and even making a run for the state title in 2011. Can the team return to their glory days this season? Seniors Kelsey Douglas and Danielle Potts know it's a tough road here in the 4th district.
Our district is really competitive. Murray's obviously really good. Marshall, Graves County, probably the best team in the region.
The Lakers hope the size of their post players will be an advantage this season. But however they get it done, Coach Civil says his team's main goal is to find a way back to the regional tournament.
We really feel like that our girls are going to play as hard as they can each and every day. We want to make this a fun experience for all of us and just do our best to compete as hard as we can.
The Lady Lakers play against Paducah Tillman on December 2nd here at Jeffrey Gymnasium. For Laker TV Sports, I'm Josh Bailey.
Each year, Murray State University selects outstanding high school music students throughout the Quad State area to participate in a massive choir experience. Reporter Kayla Little was there and brings us a few highlights today on Laker TV.
Earlier this month, over 250 high school students participated in Murray State's 2014 Quad State Honor Choir. Don't let the name mislead you. This event included students from 5 states and over 35 different schools. Calloway was able to send 4 of our own students, including Jennifer Free, Andrew Green, Faith Houston, and Shelby Parker.
It was fantastic. I had a lot of fun. Dr. Almquist directed. He made it really amazing.
Last week, we featured a story about how November is college application month across Kentucky, and we showed you that many of our students here at Calloway are completing that first important step toward higher education. This week, we're taking a look at how the college experience has seemingly been unreachable for students with serious learning challenges, but we found one recent CCHS graduate who's thankful for a unique program now offered at Murray State University. Megan Jesse has the story.
I love Fender Waster.
Alexis King graduated from CCHS in 2013 and is now a student at Murray State University, which is a big deal considering most students with a mental disability rarely have the chance to go to college. However, a new program is opening doors. In 2013, Murray State University became the first approved comprehensive transition program in Kentucky, and that's how Alexis became a racer.
There are about 10 programs in the nation. Our SHEP program here at Murray State University was the very first in the state of Kentucky, so we're really proud that we were able to get this started and on the road.
It's a great deal for me. People with learning disabilities get to go to college too.
For Laker TV, I'm Megan Jesse.
Thanks, Megan, for sharing that story. If you happen to be one of those students who's having doubts whether you can handle the challenges of pursuing a college degree, maybe Alexis Kane's story will inspire you to fill out that college application this month.
Far too often, people can't enjoy the spirit of Christmas because they can't afford gifts. The Youth Service Center is helping families this Christmas with their annual Santa Project. We have reporter Kaylee Anderson standing by to get a little more information about the upcoming event.
Hello, Laker Nation. I'm here with Ms. Hendon from the Harbor, and she's just going to give us a little bit more information about the Santa Project. Ms. Hendon, how can the students donate to the Santa Project?
I'm glad you asked that, because right beside of us is the we call it the Calloway County Teen Tree. Mm-hmm. Because I'm here at the high school, I'm always thinking about our teenagers, because most people, when they're shopping, many times they will think about the little kids, you know, the stuffed animals and the toys and things like that, which is wonderful because we're serving all of them. We serve actually babies, brand new babies, all the way up through high school. But anyway, with the teens, in the past we have had not as much donated to fill the boxes. So we do a lot of things. We have our teen tree here. There's items you can pick off of that and go buy something that a teenager likes. You know what you like. So you can buy that, bring it here, or up to the Santa Project at BB&T Bank, and then we will use that to fill the boxes for the Santa Project. So any kind of anything you wanted to buy, we can utilize from babies all the way up through the high school kids.
Well, thank you for joining us, and good luck with the Santa Project.
Thank you so much.
For Laker TV, I'm Kaylee Anderson.
Thank you, Kaylee. Students, remember to donate your gifts to the Harbor and give the gift of Christmas to the less fortunate.
One of the perks of being involved in a club here at CCHS is having the opportunity to go places and do things. Here is Haley Bergman with the story.
Students arrived in St. Louis on Thursday, where they spent the evening relaxing at the mall. Friday morning, the group toured the Federal Reserve Bank and explored the newly unveiled museum there.
But I didn't know anything about it beforehand, so it was really cool going and seeing the museum.
The group ate lunch at Carmine's, a popular restaurant for some of the city's famous baseball players. From there, students walked to Busch Stadium, home of the St. Louis Cardinals, and participated in a behind-the-scenes tour.
I like going on the field. It's really cool seeing where the players are and the dugout and stuff.
Students met with the Cardinals marketing manager, a Murray State graduate, who elaborated on the process of marketing for a Major League Baseball team. From there, students traveled to the Bissell Mansion, a murder mystery theater, where students were presented with a script and encouraged to participate in the show.
Going on all of the trips throughout your high school career, it really adds up and you learn a ton.
For Laker TV, I'm Haley Bergman.
Well, Mockingjay Part 1 premiered last night at Murray Sharif Theater, and many of you apparently went to watch the latest sequel to the blockbuster Hunger Games series.
I never wanted any of this. I never wanted to be in the games. I just wanted to save my sister and keep PETA alive.
Miss Everdeen, it's the things we love most that destroy us.
The Hunger Games is back with part one of the final chapter of the epic saga. Katniss Everdeen is back with a vengeance. The Hunger Games franchise has already grossed over $1 billion from just two movies. Both films receiving critical acclaim from critics and fans alike.
I'm extremely excited about the movie. I'm hoping that they don't leave it off where we have to wait a whole year to find out what happens, but I'm pretty excited for the movie.
The highly anticipated film has already received a 78% on RottenTomatoes.com.
I think they'll leave a lot of stuff out to save for part two, just so that they can have you coming back.
Wow, that trailer certainly was epic. I'll make sure to go see that when it's in theaters.
Yeah, I can't wait. I think I'm going Saturday, but I'm really excited to see it.
Well, in all this excitement for Mockingjay, let's not forget about the Powder Puff game that was rescheduled for next Monday.
Oh, that's right. I'll be thankful if it isn't unbearably cold that night.
And since it's Thanksgiving, we'll be back with our next edition of Laker TV on December 5th.